Abba, oh news Abba, there is news and there is gist. Hey, today's news is hot. I say very, very hot. I hope you are ready. You are ready for this hot news, for this hot gist. Hey. Anyway, let's just dive right into this hot gist. Hello gist partners, news Abba, oh news Abba. There is news and there is gist. Hey, as I said before, today's news is hot. Very, very hot. If you know that you are sitting, you are standing, just make sure you are holding something well because this is a very, very hot one. Anyway, before we dive right into this hot gist, if you know you are not following Sandy's Joyful Space, that's my other channel. You don't want to miss all the interesting things going on there. Thank you very much. You will say, Sandy, what is it? Oh yeah, tell us. I will tell you. Hey, make sure you watch this video to the end so that you don't miss any part. And you begin to wonder, how did the news go? How did it end? So please, watch to the end so that you don't miss any part. So let's just dive right into this gist as it is hot. Akufo-Addo commissions engineering workshop at Cape Coast Technical University. You will say you do not hear it well. Okay, I take it again. Akufo-Addo commissions engineering workshop at Cape Coast Technical University. Do you hear that? Do you hear that? How did this sound? How did this sound? Is it not a good news? Is it not a wonderful news? Let's just continue. President Akufo-Addo has commissioned engineering laboratories and workshops at the Cape Coast Technical University as part of his two-day working visit to the central region. The workshop and laboratory consists of an automotive section, a mechanical engineering section, which is divided into a welding unit and a fabrication unit, a civil engineering section, electrical and electronic section. The commissioning of these workshops is part of efforts by government to equip a number of technical universities and technical institutes whose facilities need to be upgraded. In July 2018, Parliament approved a supplementary contract agreement as well as the commercial contract between the Government of Ghana and the AVIC International Holding Corporation of China for the implementation of the project. The Ghana-China project on upgrading and rehabilitation of technical universities or polytechnics and technical institutes will equip 8 technical universities and 13 technical institutes with workshops, offices and laboratories. The project is designed to support government's efforts in developing human capital as well as resolving key development challenge of low quality of skills produced by the technical and vocational education and training sector in the country. That is the news. So as I heard it, I said I have to bring it for my GIST partners. So as the news says, President Akufo-Addo has commissioned an engineering workshop at Cape Coast Technical University. Yes. And they will not be doing this only in Cape Coast because they are trying to upgrade the technical sectors of universities, polytechnics, you know, trying to upgrade it, trying to implement new things. They will also be doing it in 8 technical universities and 13 technical institutions. So I think this is a very good plan, a very good idea, trying to upgrade the technical universities, upgrade their laboratories, equip it, you know, bring in new equipment, trying to just, you know, upgrade it. This is a very good plan. This is a very good idea. This will help the student to be able to understand what is being taught in class better and even more sharpen them to be more equipped when they come out of school. For instance, in nursing school like this, even though we are being taught in class, oh, this is how to give injection, this is how to do this, this is how to pass a line, this is how to do that, do this. By the time you get to the field, like, you know, the hospital, it's a different ballgame. Practicing it on an actual human being is actually different from sitting down in class and just, you know, teaching you. So I begin to ask myself, what if there was nothing like, you know, practicals? We just sit in class, learn and learn and learn and learn and graduate, and we just go into the field and start working. Trust me, guys, it would have been a big disaster. Trust me, a very big disaster. So I think that any department that anyone is in, that requires practicals, one should really focus on it and really pay attention. Like, the practical part is more important. Trust me, it's even more important. There are some things that you might not even be taught in class. There are some things that you might have even, like, you know, missed out in class. But by going to practicals, you begin to, you know, see it more clearly. You begin to get the picture clearly. So if they are trying to upgrade the technical facilities so that the students are able to, you know, practice more and learn more, this will help them to, you know, assimilate more. This will let them to, you know, be able to practice what they have been taught even better. Because what you see is different from what you are being told. Yes, when I'm telling you, oh, this is this, that is this, and you'll be looking at me and imagining the picture. But when you see it for yourself, you will appreciate it more. It will make more sense to you. So this initiative of, you know, improving the technical laboratories and all that, it will really help. Especially engineering students, they need to practice a lot. Without good practicals, I don't know how they can come out tomorrow and become that great engineer, big engineer, that can, you know, create history, make history. So what they are doing in the long run is trying to invest in the future of Ghana. Yes, because when these students come out more equipped, just imagine the impact it will have on Ghana. So when these students graduate tomorrow and start working in Ghana, building their career in Ghana and all that, all this knowledge they have acquired over the years will come in hand. So they are actually investing in the future of Ghana, if you look at it. Because those students will later come out and also work where? In Ghana. Yes, some might travel out and all that. But at least there will be some that will work in Ghana. And they will definitely help in transforming Ghana with all their knowledge, skills, and everything they have acquired. Investing in education can never be a waste. Like, never, never. And I always say it. That's one thing, like, I love and admire about Ghana. The government really take education seriously. They invest a lot in education. Apart from the free education, you know, the free SHS and all that, I also hear that they give them free food. Like, free food. Guys, when I heard that, I was like, wow, free food for the students? That is just so wonderful. Like, so wonderful. Because when the children eat and they are full, they can learn and assimilate better. They can understand what is being taught in class. Who is learning with an hungry stomach? How can book enter? Book will not enter. What the teacher is saying, we're passing one ear and flying out. So even in the primary, the secondary level, Ghana does not joke with education. They take it seriously. They try to make the student as comfortable as they can be, so that you don't have any excuse to say, okay, this is the reason why I could not study. Education is free. You get free food, you get free that. So what is your excuse? You don't have any. Go to the university sector. They're trying to, you know, build facilities, build laboratories, build things that will make the student learn more, get more knowledge, acquire more skills and all that. So guys, I'm just happy about the news. And when I heard it, I said, ah, I have to bring this to my GIST partners. My GIST partners have to hear this. So if you have watched this point, I say thank you. And if you know you're on this channel, you have not yet subscribed, I am begging you, please, don't forget to hit that subscribe button. Yes, that red one. And hit notification bell, let it do the gong, so that you will be notified. Anytime there is news like this, you will be the first to hear. Nobody will tell you. You will hear with your ears. You will see with your eyes that, ah, news about. There is news and there is gist. Thank you all for watching. Thank you for your love and support. God bless you all. Bye.